And I believe that in this week is going to be a week full of testimonies. Just confess. Let's take 1 minute, just confess. Just say the name of Jesus. This week is full of testimonies. This week is filled with joy. This week is full of favors. Let this week be a week that manifestations of the goodness of the Lord in my personal life. Raise your voice, begin to pray. I come in the name of Jesus Christ to pray. This is a week of mercy. This is a week of grace. This is a week of testimonies. This is a week of favor. At the sound of my voice across the nations of the world, just see I'm coming. My family is covered. My job is covered. My children are covered. Your grandchildren are covered. Your spouse is covered. There is grace for security. There is grace for protection. There is grace for peace of mind. Raise your voice, begin to pray. We come in the name of Jesus Christ from this Monday to Sunday. We cover our week with the presence of Jesus Christ. I speak grace for every person on this line today. The same God that sustained you last week, the same God that sustained us last week, that same God will sustain us this week. The same grace that kept us strong last week, that same grace will keep you strong this week in the name of Jesus Christ. Let's take a moment. Just give God praise. Give God testimony for His mercy, for His kindness, for His greatness, for His hand upon your life. And just raise your voice thanking. Father, I give you thanks today. We appreciate you for your covenant. You are the covenant-keeping God. I appreciate it because you are faithful God. You are mighty God. You are awesome God. I bless the name of Jesus Christ. All my friends signing in, those watching on different platforms and those on the radio today, let Jesus Christ be glorified all across the nations of the world. There is no other name but the name of Jesus. There is security, there is peace, there is healing, there is safety, there is assurance in no other name except the name of Jesus Christ. Peter said to the Sanhedrin Council, there is no other name whereby man can be saved but the name of Jesus Christ. Let's declare today, our faith is in the name of Jesus Christ. Our faith is in the maker of the heaven and the earth. Our faith is in the holy word of God. Our faith is in the price that was paid on Calvary. Raise your voice and declare, I speak today to all the nations of the world, our faith is built on nothing less but the covenant word of God. Our faith is established on the teachings of Jesus Christ. Our faith is established in the Ancient of Days. He is faithful and He keeps His covenant. To God be the glory. For those watching us through the website, we are also going live today through the radio. You can follow us through iHeart Radio anywhere in the world. Jesus Christ is faithful right now. Please turn to Genesis chapter 11. This is a very special chapter. We're going to spend time, pray some verses there. And tomorrow we're dealing with Genesis chapter 12, my favorite passage in the Old Testament. So please don't miss today and don't miss tomorrow. Okay. Genesis chapter 11. This is very important passage in the Bible. So please, Genesis chapter 11 verse 1, and the whole earth was of one language and one speech. Wow, that was the original plan of God. One language, one speech, one way of life. The enemy doesn't want oneness. We're praying today, just say the name of Jesus. Every enemy of oneness, everything that comes to scatter, whatever comes to divide, it will not divide your family, it will not divide the church, it will not divide your home. Every power that fights unity, that fights oneness, that fights this agreement, that brings disagreement, we say it will not work in your life. We're restoring oneness. We are restoring oneness in the homes, oneness in marriages, oneness in families, oneness in your spiritual life. Raise your voice, begin to pray. We speak today in the name of Jesus Christ. God's original plan was oneness, one language, one speech, One culture, one direction, one way of life, serving the living God, the King of Kings. But the enemy came with division to scatter, with confusion. We declare today we are restoring oneness. Let there be oneness within you, no division within you. Let there be oneness in your home, oneness in your mind, oneness in your marriage, oneness in your company. We restore the original plan of God for man today. We bind the spirit responsible that scatters people. In the name of Jesus Christ. Genesis 11 verse 1, and the whole earth was of one language and one speech. Now in verse 2, and it came to pass, as the journey, underline the word journey, underline the word journey, they were journeying from the east. They were migrating from where they were to another side. Now, we're praying today. This is what the Lord said to me. There is a lot of instability in the world. There's a lot of instability in the world. Men are going to and fro, up and down, left and right, in and out every day. People are not stable anymore. Some live 6 months in New York, 1 year in California, 6 years in DC, and they move to, you know, people are not stable. God wants stable people. God wants stable marriages. God wants stable families. God wants stable churches. God wants stable business. You cannot begin a farm this year, next year you move to poetry, next year you go to business. It cannot work. Let's declare today, we bind instability. We declare every child of God, be established, be stable, no roaming around, no vagabond spirit. We declare stability in our children. Raise our voice, begin to pray. We come in the name of Jesus Christ and declare stability around the world. Men are moving up and down, in and out. Men are becoming disorganized everywhere in the world. We speak today for the grace of stable life, a stable family, a stable job, a stable marriage, a stable family. We declare stable marriage, stable family, stable children, stable businesses, stable ministries. I just come in the name of Jesus that God will establish you. God will plant you like a tree by the rivers of living waters that will grow and grow and grow like a palm tree and bear fruit. You know, this is serious. People today, they just like change. Change environment, change environment. People don't want, I want to change environment. I want to change, and they keep changing and changing. It's a spiritual condition. It began right in Genesis. They refused to stay in the Garden of Eden. They now started moving towards the east. Let's pray today for those who are they are prone to causing their family trouble. Imagine some people just cause trouble. They just move from one house to another house, and then they lost their job. So we're praying today, we're declaring today that let your family be stable. Let your children be stable. Let your marriage be stable. Let the ministry be stable. Let our countries be stable. Raise our voice, begin to pray. Father, we come in the name of Jesus Christ. Let the church be stable. Let our homes be stable. Let our families be stable. Let our country be stable. Let our nation be stable. Let your heart be stable. No wandering around in our minds, oh God. Establish our children. Let our children be established in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of God. We declare today our children are not wandering from one college to the next college, from one street to the next street. We are praying in the name of Jesus Christ for men to focus. Let's use that word focus. Say focus. Let's pray for our children to focus in their school, our businessmen, our workers. You know, imagine if you change a job in January, in June you change a job, July you change a job, the next September you change a job. Very soon you will have to get a job. Every person wants a stable staff, a stable marriage, a stable home. If you keep changing schools, very soon you don't have any school to admit you. Let's pray today for the grace of God that God will establish you in the right job, establish you in the home, establish your business, establish you. Just say the name of Jesus. I am like a palm tree planted by the rivers of living waters that will grow and grow unshakable. I am like Mount Zion, full of the glory of God. Nothing can shake me. No wind can shake me. Raise your voice and declare. I speak today for men and women that are planted in the house of God. No wind can shake you. Men and women planted in the ministry, planted in the will of God. Let God establish the church in His will. Let God establish the church in the word of God. Let God establish your family in that business, in that locality, and cause you to prosper in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah, Lord. There is a blessing in being stable in life. There's a blessing in being stable in life. The Lord bless you with stability in your prayer life. The Lord bless you with stability in your business life. The Lord bless you with stable children. The Lord bless your business. Make it stable in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. So we're praying Genesis 11 verse 1 and verse 2. And it came to pass as they journeyed from the east, they found a plain in the land of Shinar. Now Shinar means what? Babylon. They found a place in the land of Babylon. They migrated from Joseph after me, from the Garden of Eden to Babylon. Wow. From the Garden of Eden area to Babylon. Can you imagine? From Christ to the world, from spiritual to carnal. They were migrating from holiness to worldliness. That is a wrong migration. Let's pray today that no child of God will wander from Eden to Babylon. No child of God will start to join in from the presence of God to the world. Raise your voice, begin to pray. We speak today every spiritual migration, every backsliding migration, all the men and women of God that are falling from grace, that are leaving the place of worship to a nightclub, all the sons and daughters that used to play music in the house of God that now play music in a club, we bind that spirit in the name of Jesus Christ. All the singers that used to sing in the house of God that now singing in the world, we bind that spirit in the name of Jesus Christ. Every spiritual migration from Eden, from the Garden of Eden to Babylon, we bind it. We pray today that no child of God will migrate to Babylon in a time like this. Now, church, this is a spiritual dispensation. Let's pray today that no child of God will fall because of the hardness, the hardship in this time. That no child of God will start to wander away from the presence of God to Babylon. Many are already falling. Babylon is falling. Many are falling away from the presence of God to Babylon, from the presence of God to human reasoning. Let's pray for our families. Pray for our children. Pray for yourself to stay in Eden, to stay in the garden, to stay in God's presence. I refuse to settle in Babylon. Raise your voice and pray. I refuse to settle in the land of Shinar. I refuse to settle in the land of Babylon. I will settle in the presence of the Lord. Nothing will take me from Eden to Babylon. Wow. For those watching around the world, let's take this decision, no matter the situation, no matter the condition, no matter the battle, no matter the shaking, no matter the prosperity, no matter the adversity, I will not wander from the presence of the Lord to Babylon. No matter the situation in the house of God, men begin to wander from the presence of God, from Eden to Babylon. I don't know whether you know anybody in your family that has finally gone to Babylon. So we are praying today that God give us grace. Don't call my phone now to the end of the session, please. We are praying today for God to give us grace to stay in the presence of God. Oh my God. Just say, Holy Spirit, give me the grace to abide in your presence. My mind will not wander from your presence. My spirit will not wander from your presence. My life will not wander from God's presence. I will dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life. I will stay in your presence. I will seek the face of God all the days of my life. When I am watching me around any country, any continent, around the world, just begin to declare, I will dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life. I will abide in God's presence all the days of my life. No situation will take me out of the presence of the Lord. Paul said, shall tribulation, shall distress, or temptation, but all, none of these things will be able to separate me from the presence of the Lord. The Lord bless you, those who are signing in the prayer line. You are blessed today in Jesus' name. So Genesis 11 verse 2, and it says, and it came to pass, they journeyed from the east, and that they found a plain in the land of Shinar, which is Babylon, and they dwell there. They dwell there means they make a home there. And in verse 3, please, this is very important. In verse 3, trouble began. And they said one to another, underline, they said one to another, they said, many have been destroyed by, he said, she said, they said, yes, many churches are destroyed by, he said this, they said this, she said this, many marriages are destroyed by, he said this, she said this, they said this. When your ears are following, he said, they said, she said, your life will be in confusion. We must follow what the Lord, we must follow what the Lord says. Just say after me, I will follow what the Lord says. Not what he said, she said, they said. Now, when they said, can you imagine, they said, she said, now listen carefully in verse 3. And they said one to another, go to, let us make bricks and burn them thoroughly. And they make bricks for stones and slime for mortar. And they said again, go to, let us build us a city and a tower whose top may reach heaven. And let us make us a name. They said, she said, let's pray today that no person in your circle will be destroyed by, he said, she said, they said. We close the door for all the evil influence, all the he said, they said, whatever said. We declare today, we're holding on what the Lord says. Raise our voice and pray. We come in the name of Jesus Christ. I bind the storytelling spirits in families. I bind the storytelling spirits in homes. They said, he said, he said, and they said, that confusing spirit in the name of Jesus Christ will declare today, your marriage will not be broken, but they said, she said, your home, your business, your spiritual life will not be ruined by what men are saying. Hey, I bind that spirit that what men are saying would not captivate your life anymore. What God says matter. Only what God says matter. Just say the name of Jesus. Only what God says in my life matters. I hold on the word of God. I hold on the word of God. I refuse to listen to this said, he said. Oh my God. Okay. Now this is very interesting. Genesis 11 verse 4. And they said, let us go. Now we see the same thing again. That verse, let us, they said, go to, let us build a city and a tower whose top may reach unto heaven. Let us make us a name, lest we be scattered. Now listen, these men were totally in opposition against the will of God. God says, I bless you. Multiply, replenish, and fill the whole face of the world. God's plan was man to fill the face of the world, to extend the Garden of Eden to the whole part, to the whole world. But here now, this man said, let us. We refuse to live in the way God wants us. We refuse to spread and the face of the earth, let us dwell in this place. They form their own camp. They form their own law. They form their own party. They form their own principles. They form their own government against the government of God. Just in the name of Jesus, every counsel against the counsel of God, it will not prosper. Every counsel, every voice against the voice of God will not prosper. Raise your voice, begin to declare. We speak today the counsel of evil men against the church of God, the counsel of evil men against their destiny, the counsel of men against the will of God. It will not stand. It will not prosper. The counsel of men and women in secret places against the word of God, against the plan of God, it will not stand in Jesus' mighty name. Now listen, even right now, some men are somewhere planning something against the will of God, against the church of God, against the truth of God. It will not be established. It will not work. It will not stand. Just say after me, say in the name of Jesus, every counsel in violation of the word of God, every counsel in opposition to the will of God, it will not manifest in my life, it will not manifest in my job, it will not manifest in my family. Raise your voice and pray. We speak in the name of Jesus Christ all around the world, all the counsel, all the conspiracies, all the laws against the church, against the word, against nations, against the will of men, against the future that God has for the world. Men want to get their own future. We're buying that antichrist spirit in the name of Jesus Christ. We pray for the word of God to be established as it is in heaven. Let it be done on earth, O God. As it is in heaven, O Lord, let it be done on earth in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah, Lord. Now, just advice. Don't listen to he said, they said. And can you imagine? Because of they said, now they are now in trouble. Genesis 11, please, verse 4. Now we saw that they want to build a house to reach heaven. Now, verse 5, please. And the Lord came down to see the city and the tower which the children of men builded. And the Lord said, behold, the people is one, and they have all one language, and this they begin to do, and nothing will restrain them. They were all given to their own direction. Nothing could stop them. They were all following Nimrod. They were all geared towards Nimrod. Let's pray today for men that are running towards a fall. That many that are running with high speed towards destruction. Just say, oh Lord, anybody in my family that is running towards destruction, anybody in our circle that is heading towards destruction, Lord have mercy, reverse that direction. Hey, oh Lord, any person in your family, in the church, in your neighborhood that is heading towards destruction, Lord, by your mercy, reverse their life. Raise your voice, let's pray. We come in the name of Jesus Christ, men and women that are headed towards a downfall. Oh God, reverse their life. Men that are deciding to go towards a way of destruction, please, Lord, in your mercy, reverse their life, oh God. There is a way that seemeth right unto man, but the end is destruction. So we see that God saw that this man was united for a wrong cause. See after me, united for a wrong cause. And that is what we see today in the world. Men are uniting for a wrong cause. Just say the name of Jesus. I will stand for the right cause. Every child of God stand for the right cause. We stand for God's kingdom. We stand for righteousness. We stand for truth. We stand for family. We come in the name of, just say the name of Jesus. All the men that are uniting for the wrong cause. Oh God. Now listen. There was a time in Israel when the son of David called Absalom seduced the whole nation of Israel against his father David. all that David did in the whole city. David was a great king, but his son raised up all the men of Israel against his father. And his father ran out of the country. But listen, God was angry with Absalom because Absalom raised up men for a wrong cause. But God finally restored the kingdom to David. We are praying today in Africa, in Asia, in Europe, and America, every man and woman that are uniting themselves for a wrong cause that will destroy families, that will destroy nations, that will destroy society, that will destroy the church. We say today, we scatter the evil cause of men, either rich or poor, that unite themselves to cause destruction and will not prosper. Raise your voice and pray. I come by Cast Sambiero. I come in the name of Jesus Christ. As many are united for a wrong cause against children, against schools, against Christianity, against marriages, against families, against peace in the world, we bind that spirit in the name of Jesus Christ. Every secret agenda against humanity, we scatter that wicked agenda in the name of Jesus Christ. Arise, O God, let not wicked men prevail. Let not wicked men prevail against your marriage. Just say after me, say, oh Lord, let not wicked men prevail in my job site. Raise your voice and pray. Father, pray, let not wicked men prevail in our job site. You see the sons and daughters of God in your job site. Let not evil men prevail in your job site. In the name of Jesus Christ, let no evil men prevail in the church of God. Let no evil man prevail in the council in your city. Oh God, arise. Righteousness exalt a nation. Yes, Lord. Raise up righteous judges. Raise up righteous preachers. Raise up righteous delegates. Righteousness exalt a nation. But sin is a reproach. We pray today for righteous counsel, righteous judges, righteous magistrates, righteous leaders, righteous men that fear God, in Jesus' mighty name. Before we end tonight, please, Genesis 11, we are praying verse 7, and go to let us go down there and confound their language that they may not understand one another's speech. And the Lord scattered abroad from thence upon the face of the earth, and they left off to build the city. Now we pray, let's pray for this. Say in the name of Jesus. Yes, say after me, in the name of Jesus. I will not engage in a project that will end up failing. This man spent so much time, so much energy, so much in investment, but everything crumbled. We are praying today, 2021, you will not invest in any wrong investment that will end up crumbling. You will not be part of any business, any project, any investment that will not work. So we are praying today that by the grace of God, whatever you engage in will be in the will of God and it will prosper. The project in your heart will fully come to pass. Raise your voice, begin to pray. I declare to the sons and daughters of God around the world, in the name of Jesus Christ, you will not engage in any project that will end up fiasco. We declare today your project will be in the center of the will of God. Your project will be sponsored by God Himself. When the Lord sponsors your project, it will prosper. When the Lord is pleased with your project, there'll be provision. So today, receive the blessing for divine projects. Receive the provision for divine projects. Receive the grace for divine projects. Receive the accomplishment of divine projects. Because your project is in the center of the will of God, no devil can stop it in Jesus' mighty name. Just say after me, because my project, because my investment, because my ministry, because my business is in the will of God, 2021, it must prosper. Raise your voice and pray. Because your project is in the will of God. Because your project is in the center of the will of God, it will prosper. 2021, your hands are blessed. Your business is blessed. Your projects are blessed. Your investments are blessed. Just say after me, 2021, my hands are blessed. My projects are blessed. My business is blessed. My investment is blessed. In Jesus' mighty name, I see favor everywhere. I see favor everywhere. Wemission family, your hands are blessed. Your projects will not end up in trouble. Your project will you will finish the project and celebrate that official opening. Let it be done in Jesus' mighty name. And listen, to end this evening, yes, Lord. Verse 7, let's end in verse 7. Therefore, the name of it was called Babel. Say Babel. Babel means rebellion. Babel means what? Rebellion. So God called the name of that city rebellion, Babylon, rebellion. We are praying today for 2021. Let's pray for our children, our sons and daughters, our families, our churches, our nation, that men would not be in rebellion against the word of God. It would not prosper. When men, like King Saul, went against the will of God, it did not prosper. I pray this one, say, oh God, let my life be aligned with the will of God. Let's pray against rebellious spirit. Many men rebel against the word of God. They rebel against the fear of the Lord. Let's pray for our children, our schools, our youths. We're praying for the move of the fear of God. No rebellion against the counsel of God. Raise your voice and pray. Father, come in the name of Jesus Christ from the White House to the prison. No rebellion against the word of God. Every individual that wants to start a move against the will of God. We bind the freedom that is against the will of God. We pray that men and women will fear God in government. I speak right now from the White House. Let it be fear of God in the White House, that the laws that will pass in the Congress will fear God. I pray today for all our churches. Every church, every bishop, every archbishop, you fear God and do what is right. I pray for all of us, oh God, in this prayer line. Give us the grace not to rebel against the will of God. Obedience is better than sacrifice. Hallelujah, Lord. Just lay your hand in your body, please. Let's pray. Just say the name of Jesus. I long to abide in your presence. I long to abide in your presence. I long to stay in your will. No confusion as long as I dwell in the will of God. Just say after me, no confusion as long as I dwell in the will of God. 2021, because I dwell in the will of God, I see favor everywhere. Raise your voice and declare. I declare for as many as the sound of my voice, 2021, as long as you dwell in the will of the Lord, you are favored in your family, you are favored in your schools, you are favored in your business, in the job site, you are favored in the church of God. Let this week be a week of favor. We release favor in the name of Jesus Christ. It is done in Jesus' name. It is done in Jesus' name. One more time. Just say the name of Jesus. I declare today that which I invest my time, I invest my money will end well. That which I invest my time in, I invest my money in, it must end well. Raise your voice and pray. I declare today that which I invest my time, I invest my money, I invest my mind, it must end well. In the name of Jesus Christ, I bless your life. By the grace of the Lord, that which you invest in, that which you engage in, whether you are in Africa, in Asia, in Europe, in Middle East, in America, you will not labor in vain. Can you imagine how long it took them to make bricks, to make mortar? And they started building that tower. I don't know how long they built, but everything they labored for was ruined. Just say, oh Lord, I will not labor in vain in life. As long as I live in Christ, you will not labor in vain. Hear the voice of the Lord because of your faithfulness in Christ, because of your obedience in Christ. You will never labor in vain. You will never work for anything that will end up being a ruin. In Jesus' mighty name, as the mountains surround Jerusalem, so the Lord surround his people now and forevermore. Grace upon your life. Grace upon your life. Your life is established in Jesus' mighty name.